from Lindenwall High School. This is The Morning Roar with anchors Basante Bundy and Quentin Baker. Meteorologist Carlos Coleman and the 411 with Carlos Coleman.
Good morning, LHS. I'm Asante Bunny. Welcome to today's broadcast on the Morning Roar.
I'm Quentin Baker. Today is Friday, May 8th.
The Sonics will have the rocket relaunch Thursday, May 21st after school. If he did not participate in the first launch and would like to build a rocket this time around, see Coach Morgan or Mr. Callow for instructions. All are welcome.
This year's prom is a Great Gatsby theme. It will be held on Friday, June 5th from 8 p.m. to 12 a.m. in the mansion in Voorhees. Prom tickets will go on sale Monday, May 11th at Ms. Vaughn's office before and after school. Ticket prices are $80 per person. You must have cash. No checks will be accepted. Ticket sales will end Friday, May 29th. If you're bringing a date from another school, they need to be interviewed by an administrator. See Mrs. Vaughn or Mrs. Keaton. Any questions?
Attention students, we're still in a state of emergency with our community service hours here at Lindenwall High School. As of April 17th, only 22%, that's 119 students in this entire building, have attended a community service hour form so far this school year. You must earn 10 hours every school year in order to move on to the next grade level or to graduate. This is what you need to do. Pick up a community service hour form from the main office, complete a community service hour activity, have the person in charge of the activity sign your form, finish filling out the form, then turn it into Mrs. Martin. Repeat this process to earn your 10 hours community service. Have any more questions, see your coach, advisor, teachers, counselor, or Mrs. Martin.
Lindenwall High School's Red Cross Club presents a community movie night. We'll be showing Paul Blart's Mall Cop. Children under 13 years old must be attended by an adult. The event is Friday, May 29th at 6 p.m. in the LHS Auditorium. The price is free, with beverages and snacks available for purchase.
The football team have a meeting Wednesday, May 13th at 2:30 p.m. in the auditorium.
Football team will be hosting a bowling night out Wednesday, June 10th from 6 to 8 p.m. Tickets are $12 and they include 2 hours of bowling, pizza, and soda. See Coach McGurl for details.
The freshman seminar class will be selling Mother's Day cards and gifts during your lunch period this week. Please stop by the table at lunch and pick something up for the important ladies in your life. All money raised goes towards the Lee Hansberry Memorial Scholarship Fund. Now it's weather time. Let's go to our meteorologist.
Good morning, LHS. I'm Carlos Coleman, and I'm here with today's forecast. Today, we'll have mostly sunny skies with a high of 84 and a low of 60, and winds coming from the southeast at 8 miles per hour. Now, let's take a look at the 5-day forecast. On Saturday, we'll have partly cloudy skies with temperatures at a high of 83 and a low of 63. On Sunday, sadly, we'll have showers with a high of 86 and a low of 64. On Monday, we'll have a partly cloudy and a high of 86 and a low of 65. On Tuesday, we'll have scattered thunderstorms with a high of 90 and a low of 61. Last but not least, we'll wrap up our 5-day forecast with Wednesday. We'll have mostly sunny skies with a high of 71 and a low of 51. Now please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America,
and to the republic for which it stands,
one nation, under God, indivisible,
with liberty and justice for all.
I'm Carlos Coleman, and I'm back with you. 411. It's that time again for another For Real Moment brought to you by Mr. Flick's Community Spotlight Class.
For real?
Do you know what year the Nintendo 64 was released? It wasn't 1995, it was 1996. On November 7th, 1996, Chauncey Smith was born, the greatest human of all time. Just kidding. On October 26th, the Yankees won the World Series versus the Atlanta Braves with the final score of Game 6 ending, Yankees 3 and the Braves 2. 2 years later, the Yankees began a three-peat, also winning the World Series in 98, 99, and 2000. The summer of 96 began the 23rd Olympic Games. The games took place in Atlanta, Georgia. The U.S. took home 44 gold medals, 32 silver silver medals and 25 bronze medals. The United States came out with most overall medals over every other nation who competed in the games. On June 23rd, the Nintendo 64 was released in Japan, and Nintendo sold 32.93 million units worldwide, 20 million of which were sold to the United States. Super Mario 64 was the most popular game produced when the system first came out. Even today, Super Mario continues to be one of the most played games in the world. This has been your For Real moment.
I'm Asante Bundy.
And I'm Quentin Baker. You stay classy, Lindewald.
Thank you for watching today's telecast of The Morning Roar. This show is produced by the students of LHS TV. Watch this and other shows at LHSTV.com.